Okay, now we can get started. Elegoo have really become known for their resin printers recently, but originally they've been doing robotics and Arduino stuff. And that shows, in a good way. Today we're going to take a look at their Mars lineup, specifically the Mars itself, the Mars Pro, and the Mars 2 Pro. They've also got a cost-down Mars C, and in the future, apparently there will also be a Mars 2 non-Pro. But these three models are arguably the most popular ones they offer, so what I wanted to find out is what the differences between these printers are in practice, and whether the extra cost is actually worth it for the Mars Pro or the Mars 2 Pro. Let's get going by telling you about the sponsor of today's video, Surfshark. Look, the internet has become a much safer place over the years, and most of your traffic, whether it's online banking or social media, is all being encrypted by default these days. So why would you still want to use a VPN like Surfshark? If you don't know, a VPN basically takes all your internet traffic and adds another layer of encryption to it. It sends that extra encrypted data to a secure server, which then communicates with the websites and services you want to use for you. That does two things. It stops your internet provider or whoever is running that public Wi-Fi you're connected to from seeing which sites and services you use, and it also looks to those services like it's actually the secure server that's talking to them and not you from your actual location. That means your ISP cannot throttle or block specific services like BitTorrent for getting the fastest speed when downloading a new Linux distribution. And also, shopping sites often give you different prices or deals depending on where in the world they think you are. With Surfshark, you can choose which VPN server around the world you want to connect to and appear as if you are in that location. Surfshark lets you use unlimited devices, and if you use code SANLADRA, they'll give you 84% off and 4 extra months for free. Check out the link in the description, and again, thanks to Surfshark for sponsoring this video. Alright, these printers look very similar. That's because they are. The devil is in the details though. They are all LCD-based resin printers, all at a very similar print size, resolution, and speed, yes. They all run on the Shitu platform, which means you get to use the Shitubox slicer with pre-made profiles, and the printers themselves are using the electronics kit from Shitu. That actually means they are incredibly similar not just to each other, but to basically any other printer that also uses the Shitu ecosystem, which is most of them actually, like the Anycubic Photon, Frozen Sonic Mini, or Creality LD-002R. Great job on that name, Creality. Each one of these printers from Elegoo is a basic but really good machine in practice. Print quality on each one is great, as you would expect from any resin printer. There are marginal differences, which we will get to in a second. None of them have any fancy features like a tilting bed or Wi-Fi connectivity or resin level sensors. These are really just basic bare bones workhorses. The odd one out is actually not the Mars 2 Pro, but the original Mars. It uses an older version of the Shitu mainboard that actually has a full Ethernet port on board that is disabled, but apparently you can reflash a few things and actually get that to work. The Mars also uses a very simple reflector style LED assembly that supposedly isn't curing parts very evenly. I tested that. And it has a different Z-axis assembly, which uses little roller wheels instead of the linear rails we're seeing on the Mars Pro and Mars 2 Pro. The resin vats are compatible between all these printers, as are the build plates with the excellent ball head adjustment mechanism, but the one on the Mars 2 Pro is slightly larger because it has a slightly larger build area too. They went from a textured anodized surface on the Mars to a grooved finish on the Mars Pro, back to a textured surface on the Mars 2 Pro. The 2 Pro models also have an activated carbon filter built in, which does somewhat reduce the printing smell, but these filters do get used up quicker than you might think, and I was not able to find where you would buy replacements. So once you use up the filter that comes with the printer, you're left with essentially a printer that now actively blows unfiltered air into your room. But it looks like you can buy the same filter unit as a standalone device and retrofit it onto any resin printer. So, yeah. The real differences are in the core of the printing system, the LCD and the UV LED. The Mars and Mars Pro use an off-the-shelf LCD, complete with the RGB color filter. Because the printers are using only near UV light, you only get the blue subpixels to actually transmit light, while the red and green ones always block the UV light even when you actually want to expose that pixel. The Mars 2 Pro now uses an LCD without the color filter. So in practice, it can let 3 times as much light pass through to expose the resin. And that reflects in the curing times per layer. The Mars 2 Pro takes around 2 or 2.5 seconds per layer to expose it, while the Mars and Mars Pro take around 7 or 8 seconds. But that doesn't mean that your prints are actually going to finish 3 times as fast too, because the Mars 2 Pro actually spends the majority of its printing time moving the platform up and down to release each layer from the FEP film above the LCD and to let new resin flow in. Which means in practice, the Mars 2 Pro is about 30% faster, not 300%. For small parts, you can actually save a significant amount of time by reducing the distance the bed moves up and down for each layer, but that saves the same absolute amount of time for each printer and may come with some side effects. However, the monochromatic screen should also last longer because it is still only being hit by UV light 1/3 as long as the others, and it also absorbs less of the light, which means less heat generated in the screen. These screens are considered a consumable. It's hard to find any real durability numbers, but the consensus seems to be anywhere between 1,000 and 10,000 hours of print time, and probably a good bit longer for the Mars 2 Pro. The replacement screens for the Mars and Mars Pro are a bit over $20, while the panel for the Mars 2 Pro is a bit over $50. They are a bit hard to find, so I put a link to the panels in the description below. The screens for the Mars and Mars Pro include an extra layer of tempered glass above them, while on the Mars 2 Pro, using the LCD panel directly with no extra protective layer, so be careful with it. The other difference between the Mars, Mars Pro, and Mars 2 Pro is the actual UV LED. The Mars uses a single LED and a very simple reflector. The Mars Pro uses an LED array with tiny individual lenses for each LED. And finally, the Mars 2 Pro is back to a single LED, but this time using a lens and an increased distance from the screen to the LED to make for a more even exposure. It's kind of interesting. On the Mars 2 Pro, it looks like the LED is actually mounted directly to the bottom of the frame. I ran a test to try and find out how evenly these printers expose the build area, and while there were some slight differences between these printers, these little test strips should all have been 2.85 millimeters, but I would say those differences are general overcuring on the whole printer, not so much a difference in exposure between the center and the edges of the build area. So, how is print quality? As expected, prints look amazing. They always do for resin printers. For all three printers, there's tons of detail and texture, and you'd be hard-pressed to notice the physical resolution of the LCD and the layer height. The pixel size on each of these printers is about 50 microns, which is also what the layer height was set to. You can go lower with the layer height, but the LCD resolution is fixed. Or is it? As we zoom in, you can start to see a very noticeable difference in how smooth the edge of each layer contour is. The Mars and Mars 2 Pro have a visibly blocky look to them, where you can see each pixel basically. The Mars 1 Pro, however, has extremely smooth edges, and basically all you can see is the layers themselves. By the way, these details are microscopic. Here's a USB plug for scale. For the Mars 1, that's relatively easy to explain. It has anti-aliasing turned off by default in Sheet 2 box, so it has no chance of smoothing out those edges. The Mars Pro and Mars 2 Pro both have anti-aliasing turned on, but it looks like it's doing a much better job on the Mars Pro than on the Mars 2 Pro. The top surfaces also look a good bit smoother on the Mars Pro, and all this combined leads me to believe that there could be an issue simply with the Mars and Mars 2 Pro maybe overexposing a bit. But this is complaining on a very high level, and you can always tweak the print settings if you want to. I also tried to print a part that falls more in the mechanical category, that is this C-mount to M12 lens adapter that lets me use these little security camera lenses on this C-mount camera body, and the adapter on the outside is a 1-inch 32 TPI thread. On the inside, it's an M12 by 0.5 thread, both of which are pretty fine threads. Interestingly, only the print from the Mars Pro kind of worked. The 1-inch thread did fit well, but none of the printers managed to create a working M12 by 0.5 thread. I know printing a thread this fine is a really tough job, but I also tried the same part on the Prusa SL1, and that fit perfectly with the default slices settings, if I can get the thread started here. There we go. That worked perfectly with the default slicer settings and no tweaking. Okay, the M12 thread is still a bit tight, but it works. And I'm confident that the Mars printers are also capable of printing this part. You just maybe have to give it a few tries and tweak exposure and anti-aliasing settings a bit. Elegoo do provide a very helpful spreadsheet with recommended exposure settings for all their resins and printers as a starting point. If we take a peek under the hood, sometimes we find some fairly frightful displays of cable mismanagement and dangerous electronics choices. Thankfully, all the Elegoo Mars printers are built impeccably. They have real CE with the proper documentation, and the power supply is even verifiably so TÜV GS tested and deemed safe. Like I said, it shows that Elegoo have some experience under their belt from robotics kits. So, which printer would I choose? Well, here's the thing. I don't know how much of a difference the monochromatic versus RGB screens make in the longevity of the screen itself, which would be a factor if I was set up for resin printing and had a Mars running around the clock. I really like the fact that the Mars Pro provides the smoothest and most accurate prints out of the box, and the print speed increase on the Mars 2 Pro in real use isn't actually all that big. I think all of these printers actually print fast enough for casual use. You still need to then spend the time on post-processing, that is, washing and curing the parts anyways. The Mars 2 Pro does offer a larger print area, but if I really wanted to print larger parts, there's still the Saturn, which actually isn't all that expensive either. Regular retail pricing is $199 for the Mars, $249 for the Mars Pro, and $299 for the 2 Mars Pro. When I wrote the script for this video, the Mars Pro was on sale at the time for $191. Now, as I'm filming this video, the Mars is on sale for $151. With these printers at regular retail price, I would personally go for the Mars Pro. But with one of them on sale, just, you know, go for whichever one is on sale at the time. But if you have specific requirements, any of these printers is going to be a solid choice for you. In either case, you should definitely also look into getting a cleaning and curing station that works with your printer. Elegoo conveniently make the Mercury, which lets you wash the print still attached to the platform. That is so much cleaner than trying to jostle the resin-covered print into a fryer bucket to wash it in isopropyl alcohol. The cleaning station, I think, pushes the Mars series of printers from being very okay but incomplete into very much recommended territory. You know what else I can recommend? Joining my Patreon alongside these legends. We do Q&A hangouts roughly once a month, and your support on Patreon helps me keep this channel independent. Thank you all for your support, and thanks for watching. You can find links to all the Marsensons, the Mercury cleaning station, as well as for the replacement screens in the description below. Keep on making, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!